well-being of the people of Metropolis, I need you to unfreeze everyone.
How about... No!
Ever wondered what it was like for the citizens of Metropolis upon seeing Superman for the very first time, knowing of his existence and seeing him perform his duties as the savior, fighting the bad guys in the process? Well, these are on full display in this episode of My Adventures with Superman. We get a great setup of Lois and Clark rushing to the scene of an accident involving a blimp that crashes into a building. While Lois is there to do Lois things, we finally see Clark doing Superman things officially, even down to the unbuttoning of the shirt to show the S on his chest. Superman isn't Superman unless he does that. Just an unwritten rule when it comes to our Man of Steel. This scene was great in its execution. We get to see how the citizens react to not only him saving the pilot of said blimp from peril, but also saving the same girl from episode 1 having a steel beam on her. It reminds us of why we find Superman so fascinating, and we see it on the faces of Metropolis's citizens. At the same time, we are also introduced to the episode's villains, Intergang, busting their fellow mate, Shoban, aka Silver Banshee, out of Stryker's Island. It was such a great opening that shows you who Superman is in a pinch, what he will have to face later in the episode. And we are also introduced to something else as well, an opening intro. Yes, an intro. No cold opens. An actual intro with a song with lyrics. This is something that is quite uncommon to see in today's cartoons. Sure, it was a short rocking tune and just short in general, but it was greatly appreciated nevertheless. The introductions just keep on coming as we are introduced to Steve Lombard and Cat Grant. These two are introduced in a very cheesy spotlight vignette. So much cheese, it would make Velveeta jealous. Anybody who knows of these two, particularly Cat Grant, knows that they are being set up as rivals for Clark and Lois respectively. Heck, they are the ones who out-scooped Lois out of her Superman story.
Scooped!
Also, the copier is broken. Please fix it by lunch.
But of course, being Lois, she doesn't let that stop her from trying to become a reporter. In other words, she gets Clark and Jimmy into one of her shenanigans. And apparently, this version of Lois Lane is quite the klepto.
You stole their badges?
No, I borrowed them. Secretly, when they weren't looking.
She's good. The episode continues to lean on the dynamic of the intro for a good majority of it. This seems to be on course for the series so far, and it works for the most part. Especially Lois and Clark's subtle romantic chemistry slowly emerging. At least we get to see them investigate the scene of the crime and Clark's slow emergence of his powers. Soon enough, Clark faces off against Intergang and looks quite inferior in their confrontation. It was quite conflicting considering that in the opening scene, we see Superman save a pilot from falling from his death and catch a huge steel beam from crushing the same girl from the first episode. But yet, he is getting bested by someone that is apparently less stronger than him. This is something that's irregular for the character and just feels inconsistent. I really hope that the writers decide where they want to take the character. At least, we get to see him finally gain one of his powers, his laser vision, at the most opportune time. So there's some hope there.
Hold on.
In all, the episode just manages to only showcase Superman being Superman. Those that were expecting the episode to go more into Clark's development as a character will be disappointed. The episode was very straightforward. It primarily focused more on establishing the dynamic of the trio and setting up Kat and Steve as rivals for Lois and Clark. The action played second fiddle in this episode. I presume that the writers leaned on comic fans knowing the villains outright. But that doesn't extend to the general audience that this series is clearly trying to aim at. In turn, this made them feel undeveloped and just there to give Clark something to do. Getting a little bit of background on Shaban was the best they could muster up. And while it's technically an effort, it didn't make the character any more interesting than we seen her in the beginning of the episode. Hopefully, the series put more effort into showcasing the plight of the villains, start to explore Clark's development into becoming Superman. Yes, I understand that the series is called My Adventures with Superman, implying that it is from the perspective of Lois, but Superman is a character that is larger than life. To ignore delving into Superman more and just focusing on his time at the Daily Planet gives the series an imbalance that doesn't do it any favor. My Adventures with Superman does get certain aspects down pat, such as the humor, the trio's dynamic, and Lois's obsession with getting to know who Superman is, but at the end of the day, this story is about Clark finding himself, his destiny, and his journey to becoming the hero the world adores. Let's hope that's not neglected. At least the episode was aptly named. Thumbs up for that, right?
Miss Lane? Mr. Olsen?
Superman! We can't find Clark!
He's okay. I saw him phoning for help before I flew in. I understand you want an interview, Miss Lane?
Superman! Oh, hello! Superman!
Yo, Superman,
Superman.
Hey.
What do you say we take this interview elsewhere?
I'd say, hold on.